Hello, and welcome to AV Tips and Tricks, where I'll teach you some tips and tricks on audio and video equipment. It goes without saying that audio and video technology has surpassed itself throughout the generations. We have gone from Betamax, to VHS, to DVD, to Blu-ray, and now live streaming. But of course, many people have had the situation of when they upgrade to new technology, they force themselves to sacrifice their old technology. That doesn't have to be the case. You do not have to sacrifice anything. A lot of people don't realize this, but you can transfer TV signals through one machine to another machine, and another machine too, as many machines as you want before finally going to the television set. And today, I'm going to show you how to do just that. This here is my pride and joy, my Panasonic EZ48V. It is a VHS and DVD combo recorder. It can transfer from VHS to DVD and vice versa, DVD to VHS, VHS to DVD. It's also multi-regions. As you can see here, it says PAL NTSC, just below the VHS logo. This means it can play foreign DVDs and foreign VHS tapes. It also has many, many different ports on it. On the front, it has a S-video and composite input. On the back, it has many, many more inputs, which you'll see in just a moment. It also has a DV input, which is for transferring mini DV tapes. As you can see from the sticker, it also has a digital TV tuner in it. Unfortunately, it can only tune into the standard definition channels. If I tune in to a high definition channel, the screen will just say, unable to decode HD. To record HD programming, I need a Blu-ray recorder. And this is my Blu-ray recorder, a Panasonic BWT-740. It can get all the HD programming, and it can record two programs at the same time. All the recording is done inside the actual device itself. It has a half a terabyte hard drive, so you don't have to insert discs or anything like that to actually make a recorder program. Oh, I've got no discs left. I know. I just press record. And there we go. It's recording a program. You can just record it straight to the hard drive and then copy it to the DVD later on. And of course, the main reason for getting one of these things is so it can record HD programs, like ABC News 24, for example. Unfortunately, it doesn't have all the features as the VHS-DVD combo recorder. On the back you'll find it has a AV input if you wanted to transfer from VHS to the Blu-ray recorder, but they only gave a composite input, which, while it's the input we're most familiar with, is a very inferior video signal for a number of reasons. So if you wanted to capture footage from a Super VHS tape, that means we won't be able to capture Super VHS in its best quality. And unlike its predecessor, it can only play PAL discs. So if you have a Blu-ray or a DVD from a foreign country, you won't be able to play it on this machine. Which means if I want to play a foreign Blu-ray or a foreign DVD, I have to use either the VHS recorder or my PS3, which can play foreign Blu-rays. And so here are my two machines, both brilliant in their own ways. But unfortunately, in some ways, the Blu-ray recorder is superior to its predecessor. And yet, the predecessor is superior to its successor in many ways. So what are we supposed to do? I still have many VHS tapes left, and I need this thing to record VHS to DVD, but I need this thing to record the HD channels. I need this one to record the HD channels. But wait a second, this one only has the composite input. What if I have some tapes that I want to transfer, you know, maybe video camera tapes that I want to transfer onto via the S-video input or even the DV input? How am I supposed to use them? I need them both set up at the same time. Here's what you got to do. The first thing to remember when setting up multiple machines at the same time is never, never, under any circumstances, stack one machine on top of another. I know so many people who just stack the machines directly on top of each other. That can damage the equipment. The heat from the machine below can rise up into the machine above and cause it to overheat. And likewise, I wouldn't recommend putting another machine on top of the other because that load probably isn't very good for the machine below. Always make sure that there is a shelf separating the two devices. Needless to say, both machines will need to be plugged into the wall. On the back of the machine, you'll find all these different inputs. Here is the back of the Blu-ray recorder. We see we have an RF in and an RF out. That's the antenna cable. And here's the back of the VHS-DVD combo recorder. RF in, RF out. As you can see, it also has quite a number of ports on it. You have the composite video out, an AV import with composite and S-video. Over here we have another composite output with the left and right audio jacks, a S-video output, a component output, and a HDMI output. First things first, they both have their own power supply. One for the VHS-DVD combo recorder, one for the Blu-ray recorder. Okay, so I plug in one for the recorder, one for the Blu-ray recorder, and one for the VHS-DVD combo recorder. Right now, you've got the option of setting it up to the television. However you set this recorder up for the television is up to you. For the DVD recorder, I am going to use component cables. This is all color-coded. Green into green, purple into purple, and red into red. It will match. You also need to connect your audio cables as well. Your audio cables, red into red, white into white. And finally for the Blu-ray recorder, finally, HDMI. That all goes in there, like that. Okay. Now, to get a TV signal, you still need to hook these guys up to the wall antenna. Okay, so here is the wall antenna. Okay. This is gonna go in the RF in on the Blu-ray recorder, like that. And now here's another RF cable. That one, this end here, goes into there. Now under normal circumstances, you would plug this into the TV set and that'd be at the end of the day. But in this case, we're gonna plug this end into the RF in on here. Okay. And now, we take the one that's plugged into the TV, plug it into the output on this guy. And there you go. Wall to Blu-ray recorder, Blu-ray recorder to VHS-DVD combo recorder, VHS-DVD combo recorder to the TV. And that's it. Now, there's just one last thing that you need to do when setting up multiple devices. Obviously, both of these machines are made by Panasonic. Here is the remote control for the VHS-DVD combo recorder. And here is the remote control for the Blu-ray recorder. Looks about the same, doesn't it? This one has some more buttons down here, but otherwise they're exactly the same. If I change the channel on just one of the devices, here's the VHS one, you'll see it change the channel on both devices. If I press play on just one of these devices, both machines will start playing. You see here the Blu-ray recorder is playing a program that it was recorded earlier. The VHS DVD recorder is playing a tape that's already in the machine. If I press stop, both will stop playing. If I press record on just one of these machines, both machines will start recording, potentially erasing a videotape. So what are we going to do? How are we supposed to function with these machines both activating if I want to just access one of them? It's very simple. Obviously, different machines made by different manufacturers will have different commands, but they'll both have the same solution. Firstly, turn one of the machines off. And now with the one that's still running, use the remote control to access the function menu and just follow the prompts as follows. Go down to Setup, then go to Basic Settings, and you go down to Others, and go to Remote Control. And you'll see you have a list of different codes to choose from. Okay, these are the different codes that the remote control is going to be synced to. When you get a new machine, they're automatically going to be set to code 1 as default. On the older VHS-DVD combo recorders, you had a choice of 3 codes to choose from. On these more modern recent machines, you have a choice of 6 codes to choose from. Okay, in this one we're going to choose BD2, which is code 2. Press OK. And it says the remote control code on this unit is BD2. Change the code for the remote controller. Press the remote control buttons, in this case it's going to be 2, and OK together for more than 5 seconds. Okay, that was more than 5 seconds. Next, change the code for the unit. Press and hold OK for more than 5 seconds until the screen changes. The remote controller must be directed at the unit. And that's it. Okay, so now the remote controls will operate independently of each other. If I press play on the VHS-DVD combo recorder, you'll see this one started playing, whereas this one it just says BD2. That's because, okay, this remote control is set to code 1, I'm code 2, so I'm going to ignore you. I press stop, see it does the same thing, it just says BD2. If I use the Blu-ray recorder, if I press play on that, it'll start playing, but notice nothing happens on here. It just went to DVD1, just flashed DVD1 and thing. It says, okay, I'm DVD1, I'm ignoring DVD2 codes. See what I mean? And there you go. Now you can freely use one remote control for one machine without fearing of activating the other one accidentally. Just for demonstration purposes, previously I showed you how you hook up two machines to your television set at the same time. Well, you don't have to stop at two, you can hook up as many others as you want. This here, for example, is our first VHS-DVD combo recorder. It's also a Panasonic model. This is a Panasonic ES35V. It has all the same functions as the EZ48, except it only has an analog tuner in it. It can't get digital TV. The RF ports on this device are now useless, so we had to buy this thing here. This is just a generic off-the-shelf digital TV set-top box. The RF cable goes into the set-top box, and then into the TV. Of course, we hook this guy up to the analog recorder via composite input. And so now you can get, obviously I tune it to the AV1 station in question, which I've plugged it into, and I can get digital TV through that. But the key thing to take home is one RF cable from the wall into the Blu-ray recorder to VHS-DVD combo recorder, VHS-DVD combo recorder to set-top box, set-top box to the TV. And like I said, you don't have to stop at 2, you don't even have to stop at 3. You can hook up as many machines as you want. I just wanted to show you this for demonstration purposes, that you don't have to stop at 2. Okay, and so as we can see now, we've got everything set up. All the remote controls are set up to their own unique signal, and we can just to switch between the recorders in question. Obviously, you just use the remote on the TV to select the AV input in question. Right now, this is on HDMI 1, which is the Blu-ray recorder. Right now, there's, let's see, some Robin Williams TV show on. If I want to go to the VHS-DVD combo recorder, go to the component input, and now we've got the VHS-DVD combo recorder, which obviously doesn't have a high-definition tuner, just a standard-definition tuner. And if I wanted to go to the set-top box, which is hooked up into the old analog-only recorder, I got the analog recorder hooked up to the component input on this, composite input, sorry. And as you can see, we've got digital TV on that now. So the key thing to take home is basically just remember which input you plugged your recorder into. In this case, for the Blu-ray recorder, it's HDMI 1. For the VHS-DVD combo recorder, it's component input. And finally, for the set-top box, it's the composite input. And there you go. And so, that's how you connect multiple video recorders to your television set at the same time. Tune in next time for more AV tips and tricks. I'm Jarrah White. Goodbye.